Hey, what's up YouTube? So as per the video title, I'm here today to show you how to assemble an RGB LED harness to stuff into whatever you feel like putting it in. Except there, you weirdo. As usual, I will be leaving links to all the products I use in the video's description and going over all the things to be aware of when putting together an LED harness. So let's begin by going over the products you're going to need to do this. Obviously, you're going to need some LED strip. This kind of goes without saying. Secondly, you're going to need strip to wire adapters. These wonderful little things make it so you don't have to solder anything. Third, you're going to need some signal wire. I'm just going to refer to this from now on as LED wire. I added an optional quick disconnect female to female RGB connector. And then you're going to need an RGB controller. I went with a Bluetooth one because I like being able to control the color with my phone. Lastly, you're going to need zip ties, heat shrink tubing, electrical tape, scissors, pliers, wire strippers, a fuse tap, and a barrel plug adapter for the controller. So let's begin. I start first by cutting two sections of LED strip about 2 feet long. You could be more precise and actually measure the width of your footwells if you want. I just didn't feel it was necessary. Next, you're gonna have to attach a wire connector onto the LED strip. It's pretty straightforward. You just push the strip all the way in and then close the latch. The connector will pierce the strip, creating contact. Then take your LED wire and separate the four wires from each other about an inch, and then put them into the connector. I recommend using pliers to close the latch. They can be kind of rough on the fingers. Then it's just a matter of repeating the same process a few times and then you'll have yourself an LED harness. I don't recommend ever using double-sided tape that comes with LED strip. It's really cheap and doesn't work well. I either zip tie the strip where I want it or remove the double-sided tape that comes with the strip altogether and replace it with proper 3M double-sided tape. However, if you want to ignore my advice and use it anyways, make sure you peel back the paper before attaching the connectors to the strip. Make sure you cap off the end of your harness. There's 12 volts and 3 grounds exposed. If you don't do this, you may risk shorting something out if they touch metal. Don't be lazy. This is not where you can take a shortcut at. Now I'm adding a quick disconnect female to female adapter. This is an optional step, but makes things nice and tidy when you connect the controller to the harness. Here you see me using heat shrink tubing. This is technically optional. You can get away with using electrical tape, but I don't really recommend it as it doesn't look as good. Once that's all done, test your harness and make sure everything is working correctly. I'm powering the controller with a 12-volt USB adapter. I glued in some leftover suede in an attempt to prevent light from bleeding through the gaps, and it ended up working surprisingly well. Once you have everything in the car, test it to make sure it's working properly before you finish installing it. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, then consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.